Hi, Paul Donovan here from avtechnician.ca, your AV technician guide about tips and tricks on YouTube. One of the things I found when I first started doing professional audio as an AV technician was there was a button on the mixer that said phantom power. I thought, wow, do I have a Phantom of the Opera thing going here? I don't know. But as an AV technician, I'm supposed to know everything, so I did some investigating and I found out what it all was about. There are many microphones on the market, various types and things that do many different things, but what I discovered is sometimes microphones need a little bit of power. Yeah, you say, well, sure, okay, there's power running through the wire, right? But the thing is they need to have a little bit of extra power to operate. Now, sometimes you can get a microphone that has a battery in it. Just sometimes a little button battery or even a AAA or a AA battery. And then other microphones that need power, but the only way they can get power is by being plugged into your mixer board. So, if you're planning to plug your microphone into a mixer board or anything, and you're only using a quarter-inch unbalanced connector, or possibly an 1/8th connector if you're, let's say, plugging it into your computer, you'll find that most of those microphones don't really need electricity other than what happens through the natural process of the vibrating head on a microphone. But sometimes those microphones will have a built-in battery. And so these types of microphones, sometimes called condenser microphones, they have built-in batteries. Now, if you're going to connect a microphone to your mixer board and you're using a microphone, say something like this. This is a microphone that connects up using the XLR connection. Likewise, a microphone something like this that hooks up again with the XLR connection. These kind of microphones wish and desire to have a little bit of extra juice in the form of phantom power provided by your mixer. You'll notice if you're looking at your mixer, you'll notice that there's quite often a button. And this button is there to turn the phantom power on or off. If you have some of the larger mixers, you might actually have a button that is independent for each of the microphone channels. Phantom power is only passed through the XLR channel, the balanced cable of an XLR connection. Generally speaking, you do not get balanced power running through a quarter-inch jack. Even if you do have a balanced TRS jack, you often do not see phantom power running through those jacks. Now, a slimline microphone such as this, sometimes called a gooseneck because it is flexible. So sometimes you'll see gooseneck microphones. They, generally speaking, they need phantom power. Also, similar type of microphone you might see, say, is a choir microphone. I'm going to be talking in another video about choir microphones and how to microphone a choir or acoustical musicians. But for now, we're just going to talk about the phantom power that is needed by things like a slimline microphone. Some studio microphones, sometimes those ones that stand up and so on that you see in studios, they also need some form of power. But oftentimes they have built-in power because they're very specialized and they want to control the source of the sound and they don't want to pass any unusual sound. So as I said, on your mixer board, you probably have a single jack, a single button that turns the phantom power on with a little red, or in my case, I sometimes see blue. Or you might be lucky to have a mixer board where you have an individual button that you can press to provide phantom power to individual microphone channels. Now that is really handy when you're trying to do something where you may have devices, microphone devices, that would actually have difficulty with having phantom power. One of the most classic examples of a microphone that typically gives trouble with phantom power is a thing called a PZM, or some people call them perimeter microphones. Perimeter microphones, it's about a 50-50 chance whether it's going to need phantom power or not. I have found that it's best to just check it out carefully, turn the phantom power on and see if it works. If you need to run phantom power all the way on everything, like you only have the single switch, then you need to be cautious in case you do have any microphones that are sensitive to phantom power. Another microphone that you often will see is like a shotgun microphone that is used in the movie industry or the film industry or the newscasters, the news reporters. oftentimes these microphones have batteries in them, but they also have a little switch on the side that you can turn the power on or off, as well as different impedance levels and so on. So often you'll find shotgun batteries, microphones that way. So there is another type of microphone called the push and talk microphone. This one, yes, they have come in a wide variety of quality of microphones, especially on the push to talk switch. If their microphone requires phantom power and you didn't pay rock bottom price for the microphone, the push to talk microphone, you probably won't have any trouble feeding phantom power into the device. And because what they do is the push to talk cuts the other channel that doesn't cut the power. And basically the idea of the push to talk button is to turn on and off the microphone. But some of the cheaper ones, when you do the push to talk, it cuts both the phantom power and the signal for the microphone. And every time you push the button, you get a little tiny crackle. And so quite often that's a sign of you having a low quality microphone, or quite possibly a microphone that doesn't actually need phantom power and you are feeding it phantom power, thus creating the potential for the crackle or even a short out. So essentially is that's the sort of the history of what it is. It's 48 volts of power running through the wire at a very low wattage. It's not like you're going to get electrocuted. And it's important to remember that generally speaking, I find for myself anyway, when in doubt, turn on the phantom power. I find in almost every situation that I go to when I'm doing sound, I find that I need the phantom power more than I don't need it. So that's why I always say, if you're in doubt, turn it on. Now, I can remember doing a couple of events, and this is a bit embarrassing, but I've done a couple of events where somehow, accidentally, the phantom power has gotten turned off, especially on the mixer boards where it's just a single button. And I'm like, what's going on? The microphone on the lectern is not working. Oh, no. I run up with a wireless handheld microphone and hand it to the speaker. Oh, I'm so embarrassed because I'm so unprofessional allowing my equipment to fail. And I walk back to my mixer board and I see that the light's off. Oh no, it's really embarrassing. So always keep an eye that things like phantom power, if they're on, they don't get accidentally turned off. If they're off and you're not getting microphones working, turn it on and you'll save the day. So there you have a brief summary of what is phantom power. This is Paul Donovan from avtechnician.ca. Please check out our website at www.avtechnician.ca and subscribe to this channel to keep up with what's happening in the world of AV technicians. Thank you for watching.